Now, the airline aren't making a big point about them being Muslim, and the US authorities are saying that they do not bar people on grounds of religion or their culture. So why is it important that they were Muslim in this particular case?
Well, it's important to recognize that we expect and take US's assertion on its face value that they do not discriminate based on religion. The leader of the free world, you'd expect them not to do so. However, unfortunately, what happened is we know the debates, public debates around Muslim identity in the US, and it's been under tremendous focus since Donald Trump's infamous comments. So in the light of that, what we do know is that a number of families were denied boarding on flight. They followed the procedure, i.e. they put their details through online, they were cleared, and they had all the clearance to go to US. As they arrived for boarding, they're refused. All the cases that we know, yes, there are not many, but of all the cases that we know, 10, 11, 12, 15, whatever, it so happens that all of them are Muslims, and none of them were given proper reason as to why they refused entry to the US.
Which is the great frustration, isn't it, in the Muslim community, if I can call it that.
Absolutely. Look, nobody rejects, nobody refuses, or nobody denies the US has a right to refuse entry to people that it deemed not appropriate. The issue isn't about refusal. The issue is on what ground are they being refused, and should, is it really befitting for a free country based on rule of law that the US is and has a glorious history, is it befitting of a nation like that to refuse entry to people without giving them proper explanation? And in some cases, this family of 11 people, they'd be out of pocket by £9,000.
It's because it's about intelligence, though, isn't it? And you understand that they can't share intelligence.
Well, unfortunately, you see, everybody appreciates that, but everybody must also have recourse to law. And it seems like all this intelligence seems to relate to specific Muslim families. I know a friend, for example, who turned away from the airport. You know, he was a senior lecturer at a university in this country, a respectable man. Nothing known about him that could possibly question. So when you refuse entry to somebody like that, it tarnishes their reputation in the wider society. It creates strike and fear in the current climate. And so they have every reason to have an opportunity to challenge any evidence against them in a proper process. So it's for that reason that we need to have it. And also, if you have intelligence, you know these people are coming. They put their details. You've cleared them. Why didn't you take that action beforehand? Why does it have to be right at the gate of boarding?
Yeah, and the argument there, as Richard Quest was explaining, was that there are these last-minute checks that the Americans do ahead of the flight leaving, so there's a separate set of checks which wouldn't have come up when they applied for the visa.
Well, I can understand that, but if people provide details weeks and weeks ahead, knowing that the repercussion of it, both in terms of US's image in the world, but also in terms of the ramification for the individual families, one would have thought that it would be an exception where this happens. Unfortunately, only this month we have known good few of the people, and there are many who are unwilling to come forward saying that they have faced the same fate.
Is that making some people that you know apprehensive about traveling right now?
Well, I think there are. I mean, I have relatives in the US, and I think my father probably would be a bit skeptical about me wanting to go to US. I don't think he should, but nevertheless, it does send the wrong message, and it doesn't go with US's image.